Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers, this is Clémence, I talk about fragrance, welcome back. I'm doing a fragrance haul of the recent addition to my collection, so I would get a bit comfortable. We're just gonna chill together, so take a tea, let's unbox all of this. First thing I'm gonna show you today, I want to introduce to you candles, but they're fragrant candle, proper scented candle. I'm really happy to show it to you because these are qualitative. It's called Yaga Candles. It's a proper new brand, so you know, with lockdown, everything that happened, I think a lot of business started to blossom, and we are lucky to have new houses, very qualitative. Just to let you know, before I've done an IGTV on Instagram, so you can have a little look. I had to do it because the unboxing was just magical, honestly. Like, it came in those beautiful boxes like this and like that. When you unbox it, you have the proper like silk tissue. It's the name, the logo, it's so beautiful, honestly. Yaga candles are created by a beautiful lady. She's doing handcrafted luxury scented candles and wax melt as well. The little silk paper like this, you open it, you have the brand name, and smells so good, and they look like this. So first of all, they're very artistic, they're very beautiful. So when you burn them, they have sparkle or they have different colors. It's so pretty, smells really nice. I started to burn this one, this colored one, because it smells slightly greener, I think a bit like flowery greener, beautiful. The scents are very creamy. I think she used coconut wax, so basically all of them smells a bit like yummy and creamy. It's so beautiful. It diffused in the room very nicely. They use very qualitative ingredients and you can really smell it. When I was smelling the candle, so this one is my favorite. I show you, it's called Oud, Cocoa and Patchouli. First of all, the packaging, I mean, it's beautiful. It's watercolored, it's heavy. It's a proper heavy candle. And also, oh my god, I've already burned quite a lot, but I love it for the evening because, sorry, you can hear a bit of these builders, but I have to deal with it, you know. Oud, Cocoa and Patchouli, it smells a bit like warm, cozy, a bit oriental, obviously, with the oud, but no, it's a creamy oud. It doesn't smell animalic. It's so beautiful and it's so yummy, like you want to eat it. I burn it in the evening and it's so relaxing and so comfortable. It felt so cocooning and it's proper heavy. It looks beautiful as a display, and I just really like it. Even the cap is beautiful. It's slightly like wooden like this. Oh, it's beautiful. Label is very artistic. When I received mine, like, it's those watercolors are just so beautiful. It's a piece of art. The price is amazing. Talking about the price, if you want to get yourself one candle, I mean, for a gift, Christmas is approaching, it's such a beautiful gift. It's packaged in the most amazing packaging ever, so trust me, you will be very happy. I've got a discount code, it's CLEM10, so you can use that on the website. Everything will be in the description down below, so no worries, you'll have all the details. But I really recommend the candles. There's the oud, rose and vanilla. Again, so creamy, even more creamy than the other one, like this warm vanilla, you know, very addictive scent. You've got the Cuban tobacco, oak and fig, a bit more greener, slightly smoky but not too much, again quite cozy. And fig is always so relaxing, so it's not as creamier than the other one. I would say it's a bit more drier. I feel myself like drinking some cocktail with this. And the one that is burning over there is called Gardenia Sweet Pea and Rose. Smell a bit like more springy but still quite creamy. It's a nice floral with a bit of green touch, and everything that smells slightly greener in florals for me is so elegant. So proper elegant, proper qualitative candles. So if you want to treat yourself, you know what to use, go to the description, but really highly recommend those ones. Next thing that I received recently, and for that I'm gonna put my niche fragrance cap. Please comment on that. Comment on the cap. I am waiting for your comments. Hey, it's cool, no? Like, when I'm gonna do my groceries, everybody will know, hey, only niche in here. No, I'm joking, we're not snobbish. It's perfect for a fragrance lover, no? So this is coming from nicheperfume.net, Spanish website that you sell a lot of niche fragrances house. So if you want to treat yourself and discover something different, they've got a lot of brands that I didn't know as well. This brand that they sell that is great is called Spirits of Kings. We need to talk about the packaging. This is the packaging. This is just the simple packaging. How beautiful is that? It's like there's a big like ruby on top and it's proper heavy. And the price is like alright for niche fragrance. I was surprised actually. This is called Alter. I would say it's a slightly more feminine fragrance, but easy if men's like you're not afraid of flowers. It smells a bit like ambery to me. Amber, a lot of flowers. There's a bright, I think, lemon touch at the beginning, but then it's really going to the flowers. I could smell a lot of ylang ylang myself. Ylang ylang smells very fragranted, yellow tone. Very bright and sunny. So powdery. The first time I smelled it, I was like, oh my god. You know the fragrance you spray and you can imagine instantly like smell it? It's a bit like oriental type of vibe as well. There's this incense-y touch, you know, that is projecting a lot. Very powdery, which I think is so, so beautiful. I'm very surprised. It's ultra sexy. I would say on a lady, it will be ultra charming. But this powdery effect gives really something. And ambery gives you something very mysterious. Very, very nice house, and I can't wait to try the other ones. So I will need to sample the other one because I think this is really a house that you need to discover. But look at this, I mean, how pretty. Next is that one that I wanted to talk about today is one of my fellow fragrance YouTuber, and this is from Mr. Smelly. We all know him. I'm a fan of his work and I really appreciate sometimes that he's going a bit like more vintage way. He's always like with a very good taste. So when I heard he was launching his fragrance, I was like, oh my god, this is gonna be pure heaven, and it is. So this is from the brand Norton & Wilson, Gravitas. You know, we were waiting for it, we were all excited about this launched bottle. It's pure luxury, it's heavy, the details are beautiful, label is absolutely stunning and detailed. It gets the codes of a vintage gentleman fragrance with a modern approach. I think it's because you've got this more slightly oriental vibe again going on, like I think there's some amber and stuff like this, so it gives something a bit more rounder and sexy to a gentleman scent. And this is blended to perfection. Everything is just nicely balanced in this fragrance. You've got this very green tone that is giving that gentleman barbershop vibe, you know, vintage vibe, but this warmness after that is picking up after is making something ultra modern. So it's the ultimate for me gentleman fragrance. If you're looking for something to wear for many occasions, I think for fall and winter is good because it's got a lot of character to me. Powerful, like manly, so, so classy. This is really worth the price as well. The price is classy. It's amazing, the price for the quality you get of the ingredient. You can really smell there's been a lot of work to that, to the packaging, from the scent. So I'm really happy to present it to you. And I would say, you know, it's always nice to support your fellow fragrance YouTuber, but especially when they do a work like that, like you just want... It's very easy. The thing I wanted to talk about, we stay a bit in this oriental vibe, and this is called Arige Fragrances. Again, it's something ultra affordable. I mean, have a look at the website. You will see the prices, you will melt down. If you want to try fragrant oil, and if you want to try wood oil or things like that, but you're not too sure if you're going to like it, this house brand is quality, refinement, ingredient are beautiful, the scents so amazing, and they're powerful. These are projecting. This does the job of the spray, definitely. So the packaging are very luxurious as well. They come in these little box like this, which is very cute. Proper heavy. It's beautiful. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh my god, I don't want to break it. So clumsy. My favorite at the moment is called Zaratu Rose Vanilla Scent. So a lot of heavy rose with a creamy vanilla, and it's opulent. I've put that as a layer and I've put that on its own, and it's projecting everywhere. I had some compliment at my workplace and the person actually purchased this like 5 minutes after, because with a price like that, you can't go wrong. There's also this one that I've got inside that is called Houdini. If you like oud fragrances, and you want something a bit more intense, that will be this one. One of my favorite that is called Bewitch, that is a bit more delicate and refined, but I really like it. It's got that very mysterious and incensey Irish fragrance. Honestly, have a little look, it's absolutely stunning. Next fragrance, the new Ariana Grande REN. All know Cloud for being a dupe of the Baccarat Rouge, a bit more sweeter, okay, a bit more cheaper, okay. I personally have Thank You Next as well, if you love coconut, sweet coconut. And I had to blind buy this fragrance because, I mean, for the price, you can't go wrong. I genuinely love the packaging. I know for some people it's a bit too much. For me, I love it. It gives me that cellar mood vibe, and I really like anything a bit more fantasy, so I don't mind. The sweetness of the usual Ariana Grande fragrance. Cheap, so you can't expect really the same quality of ingredients. It smells a bit more synthetic, but it's a nice fragrance for daytime, I would say. I love it because there's a lot of sweetness, but there's a touch of lavender, so it makes it a bit more soothing and comfortable. It's a bit more lighter in sweetness than the other one, and I think it's a great addition. I wear it quite a lot those days when I want to feel a bit more girly, obviously. It's very trendy as well, you know, lavender is on trend at the moment. I feel it was not as long lasting as the other one, that's the only point I would say something, but with the price, honestly, I don't want to even complain. I can't, like, it's a nice scent, you know. Talk about my new fragrance from Théo Cabanel quickly. I need to do a video on all the fragrance. I've got all the samples, so I can do it, but I just wait a little bit anyway. Cassar is more masculine tone, definitely, but I really like it on me. Beware that this scent is very leathery and it's got really that a bit animalic tone, so it's not on the taste of everyone. I had somebody told me that I my fragrance is a bit extreme. but I personally really like it, so I don't mind, to be honest. I think if you like a proper animalic oud, you're gonna love this one. It's a leather jacket as well, so it's projecting and monk character. Please don't overspray this fragrance because I've made the mistake of overspraying it, and really, like, I was intoxicating all the area, all the street, I think. But that's nice to have a fragrance that is staying that long. It's a really nicely blended fragrance, and if you like leather, if you like oud, you're gonna absolutely enjoy this one. There's this luxurious tone as well with saffron, so a bitterness, a sugar bitterness in there. Really enjoy it. It gives a lot of character, but I think you need the good audience to wear. You know, I've done a video on solid fragrance about Fulton and Rogue that I really like, so they've done a new one which is in a matte white packaging, which is so beautiful. Always the nice click, it's so classy, the packaging. You can put that in your bag quite easily, which I like. I always like to have a fragrance in my bag in case I want to top up or I'm going out or something like that after work. This is called Medicine Bow. It smells much more greener, there's a much more acidic tone, and there's a bit of note of cannabis. So this green, you know, charming note. I feel with a green fragrance that could be really nice to layer actually, but I really like it. I mean, you can smell these notes of cannabis that is there, but I really enjoy it, this grassy kind of tone. It's again such a really nice creation. The solid fragrance are very qualitative, so the new one, Medicine Bow, beautiful. Okay, we're gonna stop there because otherwise I'm never gonna stop talking. I'll do maybe another one. I saw I could do or present everything that I had today, but I think it's just a bit too much, so we do another haul maybe soon. And I hope you liked it. Please subscribe to my channel, leave me a little like if you enjoyed it. Thank you for all your support and your nice comments. Tell me maybe which are the new addition to your collection. I will be interesting to see that. Thank you for everyone that goes to my uTip account in the description box to give me a little contribution. It's always helpful. I wish you a lovely, lovely day, evening. Bye now.